My day-to-day name is Shelby Gange, and I go by Shelbitron Prime. And actually, people call me Shelbitron now pretty much on a daily basis. My coworkers, my boyfriend, my friends, everybody calls me Shelbitron. I got into it in February. I had a friend who just called me one day, and she was like, hey, we're starting. We have this meeting. You should come. And I was like, okay, sure. I had never heard of it. Never touched skates except for like a birthday party, I think, when I was 6 years old. I picked it up actually really quickly, or at least from what I hear. I spent a lot of time on the floor for the first couple months, fell down a lot, but I think I've grasped it pretty well. I'm a psych major, and I actually work with our junior league because I'm going to school for delinquent teenager counseling. So working with kids is kind of my thing. And then I work at Point Bank. I'm a teller. It's crazy. Like, my world stops the second I walk in these doors. And it's been that way since day one. Like, the second I'm on the track, nothing else matters. And that's really all I think about the whole time I'm there. Very focused.
I just fell in love with the whole group of women that were out there and felt like it was a great place to belong. And I love to skate. I love to skate. So I could do something that I loved and something that was fun and be with a really dynamic group of women. And that's how I got here. I've been a wife for 18 years and I'm a stay-at-home mom. I have 3 children. And my friends, well, they can't believe that I do roller derby, but they say, man, at the end of a really bad day when your kids have just been like nuts and all that, don't you really want to get out there and hit somebody? And I do. I get to have a good release out there. And so that contact and just the putting 100% of myself into it, it does. It's a great release. My kids think it's awesome. My 5-year-old in kindergarten said today, I told my class that my mommy is a skater. And I said, what did they think about that? And he said, well, Ardian went, so they think it's super cool.
Empowerment, oh gosh. I take derby really seriously. Even off the track, if people are like, oh, you're too little to play derby, I'm like, well, first of all, I'm a jammer, so no, I'm not. Then, like, I don't know, getting hit makes me really angry, but I love the contact and I love, like, kind of the brutality of it. Like, that's what I think really draws me to it. And it is just so athletic, and like I said, nothing else matters. It is so empowering, and I feel like I can take on the entire world whenever I'm on that track. It is crazy.
I'm a little person. Oh, yeah. I'm 5 feet tall. I weigh about 125 pounds. Most people tower over me. I've never minded being short, but a lot of people think when you're a short little person that they can push you around a little bit. And I'm a strong person. I knew that if I could get out there and do the hits and play blocker, that I could knock some big people over. And sometimes I do. I don't always get the hit, but I can hit one of our big players and knock her over, and she's about 220 pounds. If I get in there right and I put myself behind it, and that's empowering. One of our coaches told me, you're a little bomb. And I loved to hear that. That was awesome.
How does it feel to hit a girl? Well, when I'm on the track, it feels really awesome. If I hit a girl and I take her down, I'm really proud of myself. But I'm only proud of myself if I do it correctly. There's like rules about hitting. There's like a proper contact zone. Like you can't go up to someone and like hit them in the back. And you also can't like elbow someone and you can't hit them in the face. So occasionally, you know, when we're out practicing and I accidentally like back block someone and hit them in the back and then they fall down, I go home feeling guilty because I've done something wrong and I wasn't supposed to. So I try to concentrate on when I hit someone to do it fair and play the game fair. But it feels awesome. One of the common misconceptions about roller derby that I'm confronted with a lot is when I tell people I play roller derby, they say, isn't that all staged? It's like wrestling, right? And I say, no, it's not quite like wrestling and it's definitely not staged. But that comes from the fact that, you know, back when they used to play roller derby, a lot of it was staged. And a lot of it was very theatrical and not as athletic as it is today. So I think as, you know, a derby girl, it's important to know that aspect of it because people do come up to you with that question, isn't it all staged? And you have to say, no, it's not. We're real athletes.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for coming out. I'll see you at the next game.